video is going to teach you some basics about Pascal's principle for fluids. So Pascal's principle says a change in pressure in one end of an enclosed fluid is transmitted unmitigated to all parts of the fluid. So the key phrases here are a change in pressure and an enclosed fluid. So for Pascal's principle, here's what it means. I've got two containers that are sealed, A and B, and they're connected by some type of pipe that doesn't expand between the two locations. So if I change the pressure in A, I'll feel that same pressure change at B. If I change the pressure inside of tank B, it'll have the same pressure change inside of tank A. But the thing was, it had to be enclosed. So if I make a little hole in A, then I cannot use Pascal's principle anymore. Just by adding that little hole, it's no longer enclosed, so Pascal's principle doesn't apply anymore. Let's give another example. How about a syringe? Well, the syringe right now, what I need to do is I need to seal it. So I'll put a stopper on one end of it. So now I have an enclosed container, that's my syringe, and what Pascal's principle allows me to do is compare the pressure at location C by the plunger to the pressure at the opening over here at the end where the stopper is at location D. So now I can compare these two pressures because it's an enclosed tank, if you would, and so the change in pressure at C is felt automatically at pressure at point D. Now, if I remove the stopper, then I cannot apply Pascal's principle anymore because it's no longer enclosed due to the hole on the right side. All right, so let's look at mathematically what this means. The pressure at one location equals the pressure in the other location. If I change any of those pressures, I get the same change at the second location. Now, I can also look at this as a way of looking at kind of mechanical advantage for fluids. So I can look at, it's not just pressure, but defining pressure as force over area at one location, say the syringe, equals force over area at a second location, which could be the opening of the syringe. Or I can look at the pressure in tank A, and if I allow tank B to expand, I could look at the force in the area over the point where it expands. So I can look at it either way for Pascal's principle.